and he was shocked to get a message. This day, I will have your head, just like how you beheaded all my prophets. Signed, Jezebel. As soon as he read that, fear, intimidation strike his heart and he ran for his dear life. Am I right, everybody? This man who single-handedly slaughtered 450 false prophets now runs away for his dear life. And then when he ran away for dear life, he asked God to kill him. He asked God to take him home. Even when God convinced him that, no, you're not the only one, I'm with you, God demonstrated through three different acts of supernatural power. And yet, he kept on saying, Lord, no, take me home, take me home, take me home. So God said, all right, I will take you home. But the Hebrew word taken means to be taken and kept aside for a future use. That's what the Hebrew word means. So Elijah was taken away and Elisha was anointed in his place. Now you tell me, was the ministry of Elijah completed or incomplete? Incomplete, right? If he had completed, there wouldn't be an Elisha. There's no need for Elisha. Because Elijah would have done his job. So, these three saints, three witnesses I have shown you, whose ministries were not completed. So the scripture says, they, these three, among the many, without us, are not complete. Which means, in the last days, their mantles will come upon you. Just like the spirit and power of Elijah came upon John the Baptist. The scripture says that, right? John the Baptist was filled with the spirit and power of Elijah. And the Lord Jesus himself testified of John the Baptist, this is the Elijah to come. So which meant Elijah was working together with John the Baptist to complete his ministry. So in these last days, God is going to do that. So this was how the Lord explained to me that day. There is an army in heaven and an army on earth. Both need to work together. If you read Ephesians chapter 1 verse 10, it says, in the dispensation of the last days, God has made one the family in heaven and the family in earth. So there is one family there, one family here, and they have been joined in one by the blood of the Lamb of God. So which means there's no more a dividing screen or veil anymore. When your spiritual eyes are open, is it possible to see? It is absolutely possible, because God is the God of the living and not God of the dead. Amen, everybody.